Om Shanti. Today is the 141st day of a godly blessing, and in today's godly blessing, Baba wants us to open our mouth and give the jewels of knowledge to every soul whom we meet, irrespective of whether they are relatives, they are friends, they are those people who have known us from the time we came into spiritual knowledge. They might be thinking that we have changed a lot, and they might make a joke out of it or make fun of it. But God says, either you are concerned about how they think about you, or you're concerned about how I think about you. Whether it's God's love we want, or God's respect we want, or it's world and people of the world and their respect we want. So the purest of the being is God the Father. In my case, I only want God's respect, God's love. And automatically, it doesn't matter what other people think about me, automatically I shall receive their love. And even if I don't receive, it doesn't matter. Because what can I expect from people who are in Kali Yuga? I was also in Kali Yuga, you are in Kali Yuga, and slowly, slowly, once we get God's knowledge, we start shifting from Kali Yuga to Sangam Yuga or the Confluence Age. So the transition is of the mind, and we need to understand that giving knowledge to all the souls, all the brotherly souls, is very important. It's like a father giving money to you and you not sharing it with your brothers and sisters. The father won't keep on giving it to you. Similarly over here, if we get the knowledge or wisdom from God and if you don't share it with the brothers and sisters, even if they make fun of it or joke around about it, it is very important that in God's eyes, we have done the deed, irrespective of what karma or what fruit do we receive out of it. So do the karma and forget about the results. So then let's get to understand what Baba has to say in today's blessing. Baba says, may you be master knowledgeful and donate jewels of knowledge with your words. In depth we go. Those who donate jewels of knowledge with their words receive the blessing of being master knowledgeful. That means you become wise. You have wisdom within you because you are sharing this knowledge with others. You are making their life better. You are earning the blessings of people. Each and every word of theirs is very valuable because it's got God's knowledge. You're not talking about any knowledge from anywhere else by listening to other people. You are listening from God directly and you are sharing this knowledge directly. Many souls are thirsty to listen to every word of theirs. Those who speak about this knowledge and they make a change in other people's lives, other people are ready to listen to them. And they await, or they're waiting for the time when they could get to listen to God's versions through their mouth. Every word of theirs is full of sense and they have special happiness. So when there is God's words, there's no nonsense in it. There is sense in it. And everybody can imbibe, every soul can imbibe because they are God's words. Not my words, your words, but God's words. Even over here, I'm sharing God's words. This is not my creation, it's God's creation. So God says, their treasure stores are overflowing. And this is why they are always content and cheerful. God gives us the knowledge, the treasure of knowledge. And once we share it with others, it obviously flows through us. So it first enlightens us. It makes us rich and valuable with godly versions of knowledge. And so we remain cheerful and content because of that reason. Because we are not thinking about anything else which is not having any sense in it. No worldly talks, no gossip, nothing. So Baba says their words are impressive. Why? Because they are godly versions. By donating words, you develop many virtues in your speech. Now many of us are thinking that if I tell this knowledge to other people, my relatives, they'll make fun of me. My friends, they'll make fun of me. Who are you to tell us this knowledge? You were so different. You were the same person who used to play around with us, joke around with us, gossip around with us. How come you have changed? Who are you to tell us about this godly knowledge? But God says that's the first step. In the war of Mahabharata, Arjun was asked to have all the arrows ready. And he was told that they are your relatives in front of you. They are your gurus. You're supposed to hit them with the arrows. But if you don't use your bow and arrow, over here the bow and arrow is knowledge. The arrows of knowledge, not those physical arrows. God will never come down on earth and ask anybody, any of his child, to kill the other children of his. That is about killing the demons within with the arrows of knowledge, which is very important. So God says, these arrows of knowledge, if you don't give it to others, then your speech will not be full of virtues or values. You will be stopping yourself from growing spiritually, mentally. Don't be afraid of what your relatives will say. Don't be afraid of what fun they'll make out of you. God says that is what you have to surpass, because you are seeing them as your relatives, you are in body consciousness. But if you see them as God's children and not your relative, then you will give them this knowledge, irrespective of what they speak out. That's why it is mentioned that you do your karma, you do your kirat, and don't think about the karma or the result or the fruit of it. That's what it means. We always think that we have to do that karma in which we only get praise of people and respect of people. But God says this: when you do, when you give out godly knowledge, obviously the soul who is in body consciousness will make fun of it, will make fun of you maybe, but they are making fun of themselves. They are making fun of God's knowledge, which they'll realize later on. What you need to do is you need to be unstoppable. You need to keep on giving this knowledge to others, irrespective of what people think about you, because you have love for God. You have realized the truth. So they are not your relatives. They are God's children first. Remove that consciousness of my and mine, and then you'll be able to serve other souls. And you will be not concerned about what people say, the lok and large. That will be away from your mind, and that's where your self-confidence, your value, and you'll receive God's love, because you're doing God's work. So don't stop yourself from giving this knowledge out, irrespective of what people say, what people make fun of you, or what people make fun of this knowledge also. It doesn't matter. Just give the jewels of knowledge, and then God will give you His love, His peace, His happiness, because you're doing God's work, Father's work. You're distributing His jewels to your own brothers and sisters. So I leave you with this beautiful vardhan. Think about it, contemplate about it, make yourself powerful by donating this knowledge. Om Shanti. Stay safe, stay home, take care.